important to have both the buccal and the lingual tissues completely anaesthetised. If you're placing the clamp and they're not anaesthetised, then you won't place it properly and you'll have the clamp fly across the room. I always get the clamp in place first and then place the frame. The frame will then hold everything secure while you do the rest of the rubber dam application, including the flossing and the eversion of the sulcus and releasing the clamp. Generally, I hold the anterior part of the rubber dam down into the first contact and have the assistant floss this one. If you've got a skilled assistant, they will then floss the rest of the contacts. Quite often though, once the first one is done, I will take over and floss the rest of the contacts. It's just easier from where I sit behind the patient. Quite often the rubber dam is quite tight behind the clamp and you need to push the rubber dam down behind the clamp just so that there's not a gap on the very distal of the back tooth. Clamp, you can see the spreaders go in and I release it. This allows the rubber dam to slide underneath and then air to evert into the sulcus. Just using ultrasonic to clean off any plaque and stain. If you have a sandblaster, that will be quicker. This is a polishing disc, and then obviously the high speed to remove the old fillings and caries. A very fine flame diamond just to clean out the fissures so that there's no stain. You can't bond to stain. Some pumice, that's for poor people who can't afford a micro etcher. Even though I use a self-etching adhesive, I'll just etch the margins of the enamel. It avoids staining. Most self-etching adhesives are not powerful enough. The only one that I know of that is Surpass from Apex Dental. The etch is on for 20 seconds. Gloomer. You don't need to use gloomer, but I do just to inactivate any MPAs. Self-etching adhesive. This is Clearfill SE Bond. It stays on for 20 seconds and then it's air dried. And then goes the final layer of adhesive, which is air thin. Now I prefer to add a thin layer of flowable to the adhesive before I cure it, just over the dentine areas, basically to reinforce the adhesive. It's very thin and you have to cure for longer because you're curing both adhesive and flowable resin. So I always put a little drop of flowable before I apply any of the composite resin. Just one cusp at a time. I've already built up the floor in this video, you can't see that bit. My hand was in the way the entire time. Micro brush to just gently shape the blob into the right shape and then a simple probe to do the fine details. The probe here is lying sideways on the cusp so that it follows the same angle as the inclines of the cusp. If you have the buccal cusp incline meeting the lingual cusp incline, you order. The stain will stay in the deep part of the fissure for a while. Lubricant, some glycerin to allow us to keep a layer of the composite.